the original design for this drum sander, it was supposed to be about this tall. It would sit on top of a table saw. You would use your table saw motor to power it by taking the blade off and putting a pulley in place of the blade. I decided to make this unit taller. It would have its own dedicated motor. This has been somewhat of a problematic construction. The original design for this was a two-part table overlapped. There was an adjustment screw in the window or port area that was cut out here. There was a roller on both ends. It's a plastic roller, and then I put bicycle inner tube rubber over it to grip the belt that it was supposed to drive. And then there was a wide belt from a wide belt sander that went across here. It was to be the conveyor. And then by adjusting the screw on both sides, you could rack this table and adjust the tracking of the belt. And there was supposed to be a hand crank out here to turn this to feed your material through. And I didn't like the idea of having to sit here and turn this hand crank every time I wanted to run something through there. So I made a motor drive unit for this. In fact, I was so convinced that the motor drive was going to be the right approach that I built the whole thing before I even tested it. This is a picture of the power feed that I built. While the conveyor appears to be running quite well, I never could get the belt to track straight. I exchanged rollers. I swapped rollers end for end. I turned the belt over. I flipped the belt around. I tried every possible combination, and I never could get this belt to track straight. Very disappointing project. After building it three times and never could get it to work, I didn't care to spend any more time on this project. I said enough was enough, and I made solid one-piece table that you can just push the material through, pull it out on the other side, or use a push stick. This elevating mechanism is a threaded dowel. It'll raise and lower this table very smoothly. A piece of formica, and I made these elongated washers, glued them to the wood, so that these star knobs, which have these washers on it, when that washer slides up and down here, it wouldn't be scarring up the paint. When you're operating this, you loosen the star knobs, elevate the table a little bit, tighten these down again, take the load off of the screw. The drum is going to be covered with Velcro, which is the hook material. The sandpaper has the loop part of the hook and loop. And when this is turning, and this is turning around 1100 RPM, centrifugal force will throw that sandpaper out on the hooks, and you'll end up with a bit of a cushion on that material. And you have to keep in mind, this is not a planer. This is a drum sander. So we're just to take multiple passes, sand a very fine layer off on each pass until we get to the final thickness that we're looking for. This is the dust hood. Slips down over here. Locks in place. Kind of snug. Part of that is because of the fresh paint on here. That'll loosen up. This will collect all of the dust coming off of this drum. And it also serves as being a safety guard and a reminder to keep your hands out of there. Get your hand in here, you're only gonna get one shot at that. You'll take it all the way off to the elbow. The dust hood is made out of a piece of 1/4-inch construction grade pine plywood. This is all one piece. On the inside, you can see these multiple slots. I took a piece of 1/4-inch plywood, cut multiple slots, a little over halfway through the wood. Little model airplane building trick. You put water on the outside of the wood will start to expand, curve. Put glue on your former, set this in place, use some sandbags, rubber bands. Hold that until the glue dries, and you wait until the wood is completely dry. You take that off, and take a mixture of sawdust and glue and fill all of these cracks. Take a wet paper towel and wipe that off smooth. And then after that dries, this will be very solid, be very strong, still light. This is very tough. Has an appealing shape to it, also a functional shape that conforms to the shape of that drum and is going to add to the efficiency of the dust collection system. After I painted this, I had a few problems trying to get this hood on and off, and I just had to find the places where it was rubbing on this paint. It's getting sticky. I sanded those places and then rubbed it with a little paraffin, and that thing will go on and off pretty easy now. The sanding drum is made up of multiple layers or discs of MDF, which I glued together using polyurethane glue. And I have since given this two coats of varnish. Right now, these shiny rings that you see are where the polyurethane glue has soaked into the MDF. I want to keep giving this coats of polyurethane until this whole thing looks shiny like these bands. This was glued together probably a year before Matthias came out with his article on the drum sanders. And he recommends about every 4 or 5 discs putting a 1 millimeter space in there. And I want to show you why that's a good idea. Right at the edge of where the polyurethane has soaked into the surface of the MDF, in a number of places I've had these little cracks show up. I wanted to show you that because that's a good justification for putting the 1 millimeter spaces a few places along the length of this drum. Now we have the drum that's finished, the bearings in place, the hook and loop Velcro material taped and wrapped onto the drum. This has the hook and loop material. It's very easy to peel off and to wrap a replacement sheet or a different grit on the drum. Only takes about a minute to. I put these wood blocks under the flange bearing on both sides as a locator, so if I have to take the drum off, when I put it back in its position, I know that's at the same elevation as when I treat the table to the drum. And if needed, I can always put a piece of shim stock under this flange bearing to adjust that height. Here you can see the motor mount. The motor just pivots on a wooden dowel. Belt tension is provided by the weight of the motor hanging on this pulley. When you start the motor, it's trying to accelerate this drum, and this pulley will momentarily try to climb this belt. You'll see this one come slack. Sanded wood with the drum sander, and the weight of the motor hanging on the pulley seems to be quite adequate. Here you can see the drum running, turning around 1100 RPM. Replacing the hood with the hose attached is fairly easy. To use the sander, we adjust the height of the table until it's just touching the sandpaper. Tighten the two feed knobs. Turn on the sander, dust collector. And that's it. Seems to be sanding very even. Pretty handy. I don't like using extension cords if I can avoid it. I put a 15-foot power cord on there. That can reach any outlet in my shop.